Your name's Darren.
Start with that.
You know, I've done tyres and wheels for various riders over the years, but not to this level, you know, and every single little detail matters, so you've got to make sure it's absolutely bang on.
It's just we're good at our job.
That's fair.
No. Barista, tyre technician,
general moaner. Hi, I'm Daryl. I am Andrea Locatelli's fuel and tyre technician.
I'm Darren and I'm Jonathan Ray's tyre and fuel technician, and this weekend I'm working with Nicola Canova.
So when we finish a race on a race weekend on a Sunday, obviously all the wheels get stripped of all the tyres. But then of course when we get to the circuit on a Thursday morning, they all need to be cleaned, checked visually to see whether there are any damage on them. Once they're all cleaned up and checked, we bring them down to Pirelli and fit enough tyres for Friday FP1, FP2. And like with a weekend like this, with a set of wets as well, as a just in case, because who knows, it could go either way.
For most of the time I have a specific set of rims for my wets, for my dries, and I'll start the weekend as I mean to go on, mainly keep my best rims for the best compounds, which I think is going to be the race tyres, and then my highest mileage for wets.
We always start off the cold pressure. We set the cold pressure exactly the same, you know, every round for every tyre, you know, for obviously wets are slightly different, but all the slicks, rears are set to a cold pressure that we've, you know, decided on, and the same with the fronts, so that you, as you turn the warmers on and you put them in circulation, they rise at the same level, you know, because if you have more or less air in a tyre, it can make quite a bit of difference in how they heat up and how they get to reach their optimum temperature.
There should be like a job description thing that you have to be over a certain height to work one of these trolleys.
I can't see where I'm going at all.
No, no, you can't.
Tell me if we're going to hit something, won't you?
This is the part where we wish we had like someone to take them in for us. Or you just click the fingers and they automatically came in off the rack.
Into Friday morning, obviously depending on what the weather's doing and track conditions and so on and so forth, we'll, again with discussions with the riders, or the rider and with crew chief, we'll then decide which tyres we're going to go for FP1. They're switched on 2 hours before we go out, before we get hit the track, and then our job is to monitor those temperatures and pressures throughout the 2 hours prior to us going out for FP1. Come on, Dazza. All right, time to wake up. Oh, great. Well, apart from the power cut.
To be a tyre guy, you need to be an electrician as well.
We started, as all the other teams as well, start plugging in the warmers for FP1. Obviously, it's sapping the power, and they haven't accounted for the amount of power usage that each of the teams is going to use. So ours instantly go out, you know, says the power. Right, okay, no problem. There's an electric box that both of the tyre warmer racks are plugged into. So we just unplugged one, got an extension going, and plugged into another one, and hopefully that cured it. And it did for a while.
Woohoo! Yeah? Yeah.
So we went off for breakfast, thought no problem. And then Dazza spoke to Uri, and Uri said, everything's in darkness again. So you've got to come back and you've got to think on your feet, like we said straight away, right, get the grid trolleys out because they run on petrol generators. So we got that out straight away, got all of those fired up, and the wheels we know we're going to use for FP1. Straight on there on the generators and get them heated straight away. So you haven't really got time to mess about. You've only got a 2 hour window and half an hour's gone straight away.
The next rear, it's at 1.7. I want to wait until he comes in to kind of know, you know what I mean?
Every time you go out on track, your tyres have to be stickered. You get 11 rear stickers and 10 front stickers. You have to use a sticker in every single free practice and qualifying. Obviously, when they come back from FP1, anything we've used is either going to get used again or stripped and sent down to Pirelli. We get them replaced, and then we kind of replenish the stock in the tyre rack.
But it's a fine margin because we've only got a certain amount of tyre allocation.
Exactly that. So you only have a certain amount of tyre stickers, you have a certain amount of actual tyres that you can use, various different compounds, and you've only got a certain amount of rims that you can have active at any moment during the weekend. So you're balancing between all of these.
I only just reached.
Oh my god, that's like a little kid treat as well.
Because you're a little kid.
I buy my kids this.
We're generally the first people here in the garage because the wheels need to be turned on, tyres need to be turned on 2 hours before the first session. Unfortunately, in World Superbikes, the first session on a Saturday and a Sunday are 9 o'clock in the morning. And Saturdays are the worst day because they can be absolutely non-stop from the time you start to the time you finish.
Yeah, qualifying's madness because sometimes we don't use the queue before qualifying, so we're not sure if it's going to work. So we've always got other options ready just in case the queue doesn't work. And in that short space of time, depending on if the rider does 2 laps, 3 laps, that shortens your pit time.
Got it?
Yep.
Very good.
Yeah.
That's all right. Good. Yeah. Solid. Tom.
Yeah. That is the joys of qualifying.
Have a mission. They should have a separate a coned off area for us to go up and down, really, shouldn't they?
What, like a red carpet for Daryl?
Well,
basically what you're asking.
Wasn't going quite that far, you know, but just somewhere.
He's very precious.
Where we can whiz up and down with our trolley.
Very, very precious. Before the race, we will have the tyres fitted about 2 hours before, and we'll look after that tyre like a little baby, to be honest. And then it all seems a little bit non-stressful until about maybe 20 minutes to go, and then it's just madness. At that time, you'll set your pressures, you'll either tyre sticker before you go out or on the grid.
Today, we've got an option of two rear tyres. I'll sticker the front because it's confirmed, but on the grid I'll probably have to sticker the rear once it's decided what tyre we go for.
And then with about 8 minutes to go, I'll take the tyres out to the grid trolley and then go to the grid.
Whatever way Locker chooses, it's okay.
Oh, so we go with the X then, yeah.
Well, he hasn't chosen the X yet.
No, well, so, hey, he has to get to the grid, obviously, so
yeah, no, it's not going to happen. He goes on the rollout, obviously.
Yeah, no, but I have to send this to the grid now.
Yeah, yeah, I'll put an X on it, and if we need an 820.
Set it at 2.1, so the highest it'll go is 2.15.
Yeah, don't drop it.
Difficult thing.
What's it at now?
2.2, it needs some time left.
Huh? Your front's still a little bit cold, it's at 78 at the moment.
Yeah.
So I'll set him at 2.1.
Okay.
Mate, enjoy.
Tomorrow, these tyres for tomorrow morning will be Superpole tyres and yeah, just warm up. And if we're lucky, they might do race 2 as well, but probably not.
I've been a chassis mechanic all my life, really. This is the first year I've moved on to as a tyre technician and fuel technician. And the game's moved on massively. You know, I've done tyres and wheels for various riders over the years, but not to this level, you know, and not with so... Everything has to be absolutely bang on. We're reducing pressures by, you know, 0.01 of a bar, you know. And normally, if it's close enough, you send it. But because the competition is so tough on track, you know, the depth of field is insane at the moment. Every single little detail matters. So you've got to make sure it's absolutely bang on.
It was okay, considering Nico had rode 24 hours last weekend on a different set of tyres. He done really well, to be honest. And on to Aragon.
I think tyre choices were all right, all good over the weekend. I think we did as good as we could do. Yeah, Locker rode well. No real issues or anything. So yeah, overall, you've got to be quite satisfied with it, you know.
Thank you very much. See you in Aragon.
Fantastic.
Grazie. Ciao. See you next week. Ciao, ciao. Ciao.